Hanuman for those words. Priyada spoke very briefly about the opportunities I had spending many evenings with Dr. Panikkar in different parts of the globe. The one name that I remember from all those conversations is that of Professor U.R. Anantamurthy. He always spoke of him highly, and all that I know about him actually came from Dr. Panikkar himself. So it would be most appropriate that he should be delivering this year's Ayyappa Panikkar Memorial Lecture. May I invite you, Professor Anantamurthy, to deliver a lecture on the Dalit contribution to Indian literature. Professor Murthy.
Professor Satyadanandan and Sri Priyadas have greatly honored me, calling me to speak about Ayyappa Panikkar and on some subject that I'm thinking about. And I'm also honored that one of his very distinguished students, Srinivasan, is here. He brought me in his car. And I'm honored also because a great poet like O.M.V. is here. And I'm sure that a man who shared the vice chancellorship with me, Tambi, must also be here, because he wrote, yes. So I've not seen him for a long time. Thank you. And many people. I am an honorary Kerala person, you know, as Sachidanandan yesterday remarked, I am recognized by people on the street. It's a great joy for me, you know, of having lived here for 4 years and made some contribution. I got to know Ayyappa Panikkar after I came back from England, finishing my PhD in 1966. After I came back, I got to know Govindan. And Govindan in Chennai would bring all of us together. I think he introduced many great creative people in Kerala to people in Tamil Nadu, people in Hindi land, people in Karnataka. And Ayyappa Panikkar was one of them I got to know. And both of us were English teachers, and so we had many relations. I would come here to choose his teachers or examine PhD thesis and also talk about poetry. I still remember one incident. We had a very great poet in Canada, like you had Ayyappa Panikkar, a poet known all over India, Gopal Krishna Adigar. He had just then written a poem called Moolaka Mahashaya. He was attacking people who expected him to be heroic, themselves being not heroic. You know, we expect our poets to be great, but you know, he had to accept some pension from the government as he had no money. And admirers of Adigar attacked him for accepting pension from the government when they were taking a 4-figure salary themselves. And he wrote a poem. And I was talking excitedly to Ayyappa about his poem, Ayyappa Panikkar, I should say. And then he said, read it. I read it. There is a section, you know, where Adigar talks only about vegetables, how every vegetable has its own character, and then it ends up with a strong tree which doesn't have flower but becomes very great furniture. You know, it's a whole section. And Ayyappa said, I will translate it. And he put it into Malayalam immediately and read it to me. And I think he published it in his Kavita. So he used to be a collector of talent wherever he went. And I know that, as Srinivasan said, even if he were not a poet, he would be remembered by so many students of his whom he taught. He was a great teacher. And he was a great academic.